Hello, my name is Chris Enns. I run Lemon Productions, a podcast editing and production business, and this is the story behind The Lemon. Today is Wednesday, June 5th, 2019. For this episode, I thought I'd go a bit more into the why. After 7 years of working from home, we, and by the way, when I say we, I mean my wife, Sue, and I, because when you're working from home, those kinds of decisions should involve the whole family. But why, after 7 years of working from home, we decided it was time to kick me out of the basement and out into the cold, dark, wintry world. Luckily, it's summer right now when we did it, so not so cold. And there's kind of three main reasons. First one, in no particular order, is space. We've got three kids that are getting older, and as they get older, they surprisingly get bigger. And sharing a small room with your brother is fine when you're 3 and 5, but getting in the preteen years, it starts to get a little cramped. And so my basement office naturally started to get a few looks from prospective renters. I don't know. They're not paying any rent and it only costs me money, but you get the idea. Sue or I would say that me working out of the home while she was also at home went great for the most part. Some days we ended up spending more time on a conversation or argument than we would have if I had a job I had to be at a specific time. But there's also lots of great opportunities for relationship building for us as a couple and with our kids that I would have totally missed out on if I wasn't around. And so I feel a bit sad each day that I'm not there to welcome them home from school and hear how the day went, but also not overly sad that I'm missing the chaos of coming home to three kids excited to get to video games and screen time. And I know Sue has enjoyed having the house to herself as well. Even if I was down in the basement with headphones on, there's always a little reminder that she didn't have the house to herself completely. So a little time, space, and relationship is okay in small doses. It's given us more to talk about when we get back together. Reason number two would be forced networking. I'm an introvert by nature. And I also have, at times, some social anxiety and self-worth issues, which manifests themselves in my business by my brain trying to tell me that no one has contacted me to edit their podcast because I'm awful at what I do and nowhere near as good as all those other people who edit podcasts. I'm also bad at small talk. I'm okay at one-on-one conversations once they go deeper than how was your weekend, but bridging that gap is often a terrifying position for me to be in. And so staying home in my basement office is often much easier than facing anyone out in the world. And so by having an office that I have to go to, even if I just end up sitting here by myself, working most of the time, will force me to interact and network with others, even just a little bit. There's a bunch of businesses moving into the office space I'm in. The Saskatoon Fringe Festival is a couple doors down. There's a software development company with a satellite office next door. And in a few months, a co-working space is opening up across the hall that will draw in a bunch of new faces. Not to mention all the local businesses that are located on Broadway Avenue here. All potential coffee chat friends, clients, or even just a high five out in the neighborhood. And I've already run into a bunch of folks who I didn't realize were even working in the Broadway area or lived in the Broadway area. And so it's been great for just connecting with folks that I might not otherwise see. Reason number three is sometimes change for change's sake is good. There's a lot of financial reasons to not make the move out of my home office. Pretty much everything about my business just got way more stressful because of this move. I have a monthly rent to pay, tenant insurance, we have to figure out transportation every day, the temptation to spend money on food, coffee, and other adult beverages is literally right outside my door, whereas at home it was nowhere near, I could always just run up to the kitchen. But we both knew it was time. I think I'd rearranged my home office into every possible arrangement I could. It was either time for a renovation of the whole office or move out and clean it up for the kids to move into. And to be honest, summer is a great time to do a move like this because it puts off all the annoyance of having to drive in a cold car, park, and walk to work through the snow. Right now, it's great being able to go for a walk around the neighborhood, eat lunch across the Broadway Bridge, and even the commute gives me time to decompress from work in a way that simply walking up the stairs at home never could. So that's some of the why we made this move now from our personal perspective and from our family perspective. I put out a call on Twitter asking for questions about working from home versus the office and got a few questions from folks. First up from @AlanIvory, he asked, is there a specific time when it's too late to change out of your pajamas into your loungewear for the day's work? And even when I was working from home, I was a big proponent. I mean, it helps having kids around because you don't want to be walking around in your underwear obviously with your kids hanging around them trying to get ready for school. But of at least dressing up, I didn't like put a suit on or anything like that when I was at home, but at least getting dressed, cleaning up, showering, getting ready for the day as if you're going to a normal office, and but still just obviously heading down to the basement office. But certainly in the summer months, it was really nice just throwing a pair of shorts, a t-shirt, and that's like my work outfit and not worrying about any meetings or anything like that, because anything I did have was generally over Skype or Zoom or whatever. And as long as whatever's on top is okay, it doesn't matter what's down below. @AsterSoftware asked, how to deal with being a remote employee in a company where most people are on site? So this one isn't really applicable to me. I'm not a remote employee. I'm my own employee, I guess, my own business. But I do have lots of clients where they are a team of people. Some of them are together, but a lot of them are also remote. And some things that I've noticed that sort of help this situation is relying on Slack or Discord, whatever real-time communication method your business works and uses. Hopefully that is kept current and the people who are local and together remember that they need to include the remote folks just as much in whether it's joke stuff or meeting communication stuff, things that you kind of miss when you have a random conversation in the hallway with a coworker about plans for, you know, a project or a work idea, and remembering to include the folks who are remote because they obviously don't get those opportunities to just have the water cooler conversations. And even having like a general or a coffee or water cooler channel within Slack or whatever tool you're using can be helpful just for sharing funny internet moments and memes and jokes and things like that, but also just interesting observations, things that happened. There's a few conversations like that I have with some clients in their Slack, respective Slack groups, where we've gotten comfortable enough with each other that we're able to joke around and have a bit of fun in the midst of the work that we're getting done together, me as a subcontractor or whatever for them. And feeling like a small part of their team in obviously a very remote kind of way. And I think on the remote employee's perspective, trying to get out of your home office, let's say, or out into a co-working space, and networking events, whatever kind of works for you, and especially if it's at all possible for your work to help pay for a co-working space or an office space. That's what's one of the offices here is like I said, a remote software developer. Their head offices are in Eastern Canada, but they have one employee here in Saskatoon, and so she's got an office here that she works as a part of. Having that space for even the remote employees, even though they could just work from home, and that maybe works better for you for whatever reason, but having that option is definitely a perk and a nice thing that businesses could do for their remote employees and offer that as a part of the compensation package, I guess. And finally, Justin Jackson at Am I Justin on Twitter asked, what have been the pros cons for you moving out of your house? I think a few of the pros are definitely clearing my head. It's kind of like what I talked about earlier. Clearing my head before and after work, switching to work mode is a lot easier when I'm reminded of the money I'm paying to be here. Plus the drive here or to home helps a lot just in terms of switching modes, I guess, and leaving some of the house worries and to-do lists at home behind and switching into work mode. And over the last number of years anyways, too, once the door was closed, it was kind of like I was working, but not having to worry about the kids feeling bad about interrupting me or making noise in the house if I was trying to record something and things like that. Now I can just have office mates, I guess, that I could be annoyed with, I guess, if they're being too loud. And definitely I'm feeling like I'm more active. And it's kind of silly because obviously I could go for walks and things at home, but there's something about walking through the suburbs full of houses versus walking through a neighborhood of, it's kind of a creative artsy commerce area and right off the river. So I can very easily 2-minute walk to get to the river area and just go for a walk across a bridge or things like that. The novelty of that will wear off eventually, I think, too, and especially once winter hits. But at least for now, it's definitely a nice kind of perk of just sort of an excuse to go for a good little walk at lunch or a coffee break or whatever. And I think the cons so far, I mean, the stress, like I said earlier, the stress of feeling the weight of, getting an invoice for rent and things like that and sorting all that out on top of just regular business. Cause it's a thing where, at least for me, living nearly month to month, not quite, but like living month to month and like then adding this on top of it just means now I have to race that much harder when it was feeling like almost getting to the point where I could not have to race every single day of the work week and sometimes weekends or whatever, and push hard, I guess, on each of those things. So that's probably the biggest con, honestly. And the social side, we'll see, I guess. It's hard to imagine there being a con to that side, but I guess if all of a sudden everybody around me got really busy or really noisy or once the co-working space opens up and everybody's super chatty and always going for drinks and food or whatever throughout the day, I guess. Lots of events happening or whatever, that kind of stuff. I guess the con would be just being drawn to that and or having to work in the midst of all that. And I guess like a bit of the separation from home life that I had kind of grown accustomed to. All our kids are in school, so they're gone throughout the day, but just the sort of relaxed, especially again in summer, relaxed vibe of hanging out around the house and working upstairs, working on our deck, whatever, and which all those things I can still do, obviously, but it kind of feels like now I'm paying for this office, so I should probably use it and not just sit at home while I'm paying for this office to be here. So I'm sure I'll have more thoughts on working from an office versus home later on in the life of this podcast and definitely in the life of my business, because as of right now, it's been about 3 weeks, so it's still pretty new, still pretty exciting. The walk, the drive, the parking, all those things aren't, I'm not sick of them or tired of traffic or anything yet. So be sure to tune in, subscribe. You can find all the details for this show on the web at podcast.lemonproductions.ca, including the various ways to subscribe. You can reach me on Twitter at iChris, or feel free to send me an email, chris@lemonproductions.ca, if you've got questions for a future or topics for a future episode of the show. And this episode was written, edited, produced, and mixed by me, Chris Enns. My theme song is from Sounds Like an Earful Music Supply. The recipe for this episode is lemon barbecue chicken. Find the link at podcast.lemonproductions.ca/2. Thanks for listening and have a great day. Bye.